California. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Los Angeles Rams. From SoFi Stadium. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Here up the middle. They'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. Then everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. From the gun, Mayfield. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. From the 10. First down, they'll kick off the drive with Dallas. And just not a ton of room to work with. He'll get it to the 15 for a gain of 2.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Throwing on second and 8, Smith, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Charles already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
And some room to maneuver. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot. And they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
They've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot in the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football. All right, you're not trying to
find the laces and grip it a certain way, that takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how.
And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle.
So that's going to be a nice one for the passing stats. So that's how it will go down in the stat sheet. But the success of that play, no doubt, all thanks to the talents of the wideout.
Oh, he was definitely the recipient of good blocking as well, especially at the line of scrimmage. And once he got around the corner, you got the sense that no one was going to get him. Really nice ball handling, too, in order to get it to him.
Extra point up and through by Myers. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I've warned against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worse with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Going right back to Akers. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
He's got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. It'll be a gain of 5. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Mayfield. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive, and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one. And that's football 101, isn't it? Tip your cap to the rookie. He knocked that one away, but he better not relax. They're going to test him all game long.
They give him the first down, bro.
At the 27-yard line. These two teams all tied after one. Number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Mayfield looks to throw. And that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
The quarterback got away with one there. Looked like he was in line for a pick, but instead is knocked harmlessly to the turf.
Field to throw for it on 4th. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And he is going to have the Rams first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Mayfield on first down. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Brandon Powell from 21 yards away. And the Rams have taken the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7.
the touchdown. Here's Gay to kick it away. From the 10. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. It'll be a gain of just a yard, and it's second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
On second and 9, Smith.
No,
you can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it up to the running back.
One
ended up incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. They'll come to the line here, needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. Dancing to his left.
Like, this was 96-82, y'all. Like, man, come to test this, you know? Like, come on, I got the 96-82. Like, come on, bro. That is crazy. That is wild to me, bro. Goodness, bro. That is wild to me, bro. God damn. That is wild, bro. God damn.
Oh, going for Jefferson.
He's cooking me, bro.
And this is caught.
He's oh, my God, bro. Like, what is going on, bro? He's just really beat my ass. I'm about to play four quarters. They're going to be beat. Damn.
I think you can do it in
I'm not falling the fucking room.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. Could not imagine a worse
keep kicking it to him.
Or let's face it, a better one for this offense. No chance to stop passing now the way that it's going. I think we'll continue to press the ball downfield and hope to get the same results.
The same shit. That's why I call it don't work.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one?
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try to get things settled down.
Yeah, and still in the first half here, a long way to go. Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 18 more yards there and another first down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They'll find Goodwin here on the right side. And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. Hey!
Smith.
Multiple players combined to give me
first and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal, Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Not going to have much time in the pocket before the defenders bring pressure.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
Smith on third and goal.
I threw the ball, Jerry. I think I hold me on the game, bro.
Already down two scores. They're going to go for this rather than settle for three.
Over a minute to go before halftime.
Snap it to Smith. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half. No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
A second down throw for Mayfield. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
He's put up numbers in this one by pushing the envelope a bit whenever he could with deeper throws. But let's play a little philosophy here. Some plays it works, sometimes they're ready for you. And that time, they were on guard. Incomplete.
On third down, Mayfield.
It's the ball, bro. What are you spiking the ball for, bro?
Excellent coverage. Tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. That's taken on the 25. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it down by two scores.
What is he doing to me, bro?
First play of the drive there is incomplete.
This is a half where not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
You make me look hella bad when we all
Smith with an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's second and 10. In motion, the tight end. On second and 10, Smith. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that's caught inside the 30.
And he's brought down after a very nice gain. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Now Smith. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
Well, this defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
Smith throwing again. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Marquise Goodwin in the final seconds of the first half. And the Seahawks are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Myers connects on the PAT. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. He's going to look deep down the field. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. Taken from about the 12. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Drive the Seahawks offense. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far to scoreboard.
I can hear everybody
trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Oh, get it.
You're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage.
So I
think that at halftime,
yes, I don't know what I heard.
That defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He hits his target, Lockett, and he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Wait. Biz, I'll get it, bro. Don't worry about it, bro. Returning right back to Lockett. I said I get it.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
Now on second and 13, Smith. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Again, Smith. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 42. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On first down, it's Smith.
Here, bro. Bro, they got many covers on here. Just jack, bro. I can't do nothing, bro. Man, I can't even do it. These niggas be wide open. I don't get it. They be wide open. When did he get barbecued?
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this
drive. Get
a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Come on, bro.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. 40 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
A run on first down, but it's not going to get him much. Maybe a yard, and that's all.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Mayfield to throw it. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. So the completion gets him just a yard. 3rd and 7 now. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. The one side gets an interception, but their defense comes on the field and picks him right back up by getting a pick of their own.
And I think you saw the same thing that I did, Brandon. As he ran off the field after making that play, we saw his quarterback seek him out and offer a personal thank you to bail him out a little bit as the offense takes the field again.
That's into the hands of Parkinson, the tight end. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down at 4. Geno down a throw. And his throw here is going to be incomplete.
But they certainly did a nice job there, picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with it. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
And the Seahawks on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 4. He'll find Metcalf,
And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
To the air again, Smith. And it's incomplete. Threw it down at the feet of his receiver.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. To throw again on second down. Smith. That's complete to his running back, Dallas. And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Walker will get down close to the goal line, but not in. And he'll be marked down at the 1. They'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
Good work there, holding them out on first down. And this is going to be a battle down here on the goal line. Can they hold their ground for 2, maybe even 3 more play?
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Nick Ballore taking it in from a yard out. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion. It's complete.
No, no. This nigga go way over there to get you, bro. Like, that's crazy, though. Now I'm really finna lose. God damn. But I'm...
Touchdown, here's Myers. Booted away.
Oh, you
can get it down. A big mistake there. You just got the lead in the quarter. And now they start at the 40.
I don't know what's going on with the game.
So good field position for the Rams as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They give up the middle to Akers. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams holding up their fingers,
fourth quarter is out.
You saw the 4 fingers for 4-minute offense. And this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Now Mayfield. Throw left side complete. That's Powell. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. 2nd down, they'll go with Akers again. 52 yards rushing for him now to this point. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late 4th quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on 3rd?
I don't. I run the football, and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue.
And he can't get a throw off.
He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Jumping all the way from the outside, maybe getting a little early start in the corner blitz.
And the only time it makes sense to get that penalty is exactly as you described. Otherwise, he should never get that penalty.
Now Mayfield on fourth down. Pass caught. It's Ben Skoranek. He's got the first down and more than that. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown Rams. Ben Skoranek, 41 yards. And the Rams will add to their fourth quarter lead. They do tack on the extra point as well. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Taken from about the 12 and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. The offense coming back out here, plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Smith. And he's got the speedster Goodwin. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Now it's Smith. This complete to Lockett. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. Smith now to throw. He lets it fly for Lockett. Oh, that's going to be a costly one. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams are going to hang on the final play. They get the turnover to seal this football game.
I'm not going to speak my offense, but...
So it's the Rams here to take home the W. And it was thanks in large part to the play of their quarterback, CD, Baker Mayfield.
Yeah, sometimes it's how those games win. Everything's clicking, and this was one of those days. He went over four touchdown passes on the afternoon. He was large and in charge all day long.
Come loose. Yeah, I'm off the boogie. I like bitches hit like nookies. You ain't scared of no, but you scared to put on your hoodie. Man, my like Woody.